Does digital learning have a place in out-of-school time programs? Welcome to the Mary and Frances Youth Center, home to the Lobs and Lessons program. Lobs and Lessons is an award-winning out-of-school time program that works with underserved youth through after-school, summer, and event programming. Our mission is to strengthen life skills, support academics, and create a path to higher education through the sport of tennis. The center is moving forward in the fast-paced game of technology. Thanks to some leveraged resources, we have taken steps to assess our administrative technology needs and make small strides in the right direction, but it does little in ways of supporting youth through digital learning. These were donated 2 years ago, and in that time, I have not seen one student take one off the shelf. Countless students sit down to complete their homework and ask if they can work on a computer. When I explain that we do not have computers for them to use, they seem puzzled. If we are going to inspire students to go to college, we need to move beyond the shiny set of encyclopedias and into a world of technology. Most students today use the web and various technologies every day at school and at home. Yet some students from low-income families, fewer than 1 in 10, do not have the same access. These are our youth. Closing the gap takes resources, time, and planning. Out-of-school time programs offer the ideal time, places, and conditions to equalize and advance digital learning. Some might say these programs have the advantage of being able to develop and test models of digital learning in a lower stakes atmosphere than traditional classrooms. Youth have goals. How will we help them to achieve these goals? Youth want to please their teachers and be acknowledged by their peers. They want to do well in school, get good grades, and make the honor roll. Research has proven that the proper application of technology can aid in student learning. Are not the only ones looking to learn. This year, the center partnered with a VCU health and human performance class. VCU students designed lessons centered on healthy lifestyles and physical fitness and paired them with technology. The results are what you would expect. Engaged students who are eager to participate, learn, and follow directions. Learning is unlimited, and with technology, training, and equipment, we can partner to serve youth on and off the court. As a leader, my digital learning principles are as follows. Learning can happen anytime, anywhere, and should be personalized, engaging, interactive, and student-centered. Technology enhances but cannot replace supportive adult educators. Teachers and mentors are critical to helping students optimize the benefits and avoid the pitfalls of new media. Staff need high-quality professional development to effectively use technology and related tools. Pursue research and funding decisions on ways technology can be most effectively used to increase achievement and support the social and emotional development of youth. As a developing intermediary organization, the center will help school and community partners develop expertise and create tools to equalize access to technology. As the center begins to define our unique niche in Richmond's out-of-school time field, informed decisions about technology can give us an advantage. Lobs and Lessons just completed a 3-year strategic plan, and the center is halfway through the same process. 3 themes have been identified, one of which is to investigate, discover, and disseminate best practices of out-of-school time programs. Incorporating technology into this work and the upcoming development plan is not only necessary, but perfect timing. As a leader, I will take this opportunity to develop a technology plan that defines the center's policies, student safety and privacy, equipment, funding needs, and evaluation tools. With a strategic plan underway and rapid expansion into middle school programming focusing on STEM and health sciences, there's no better time than the present to join the game. A national infrastructure has been built with over 40 statewide after-school networks, citywide networks, and a workforce of about 1 million after-school educators. It's time to ensure that as schools find ways to use technology effectively to advance learning, so do youth-serving organizations that provide informal learning opportunities. From the school day to the after-school program, a pipeline can be built to reinforce and advance curiosity and learning.